But on the other hand, there are some people who say, but that original vision, the idea of a big global meeting place where people of all different sorts could meet and exchange ideas, could that really have just been an illusion that we could never really have had that after all? What do you think about that?
You know, I think we can have it, definitely. And I think it's a bit of an anomaly where our really the communication systems and our media is no longer going to be, you know, old school TV and other things like that, right? It's going to be coming through these platforms where people are going to communicate. So that's going to be where we need to preserve free speech and make sure that that happens. So I don't think we have a choice but to make sure that that free dialogue happens. And I think what you're saying is we'll end up with two different sides. We'll have like a, you know, like a liberal one, and then you have like a conservative one or whatever, right? But I would say that I don't think that's going to be good, first of all, because you need to hear both sides of an argument. It's kind of like, you know, one of the few good things you learn in law school, or that I learned that could be applicable to business, is you want to hear both sides of the argument. So if you come to a judge, right, everyone has a right to be defended, no matter how much evidence is against them. They have a right to hear the defense, to have a defense, right? And the reason why is because when you hear opposing sides well litigated, well positioned, the judge is better able to decide through, you know, common law. This was sort of iteratively developed in the British system, and we found it to be now the best way to make decisions, right, on right or wrong. But I think that also applies to anything politically. We need to hear all sides. And I don't even like identifying myself as conservative or libertarian or whatever. And I've always tried to escape being identified as anything. I probably am properly identified as Christian libertarian leaning, definitely Christian, but that's more a matter of faith, but libertarian leaning. But even that, I would say it depends, right? Everything's contextual. And for example, I was looking at some of your stuff, Tom, yesterday, as you were looking at my stuff, I was looking at yours, right? And, you know, I was very intrigued. Just your positions are very challenging intellectually, and they're positions that I haven't heard other people say and take a stance on. Now, you could be wrong about a number of these things. Now, obviously, you think you're right, but I don't know if you're right or wrong. And I'm glad you're saying some of these things. And I would like to understand some of those positions better. In the future, I can look at a lot of your content to do so. But it challenges us to broaden our mind and to see things differently. And I think when we create the next platforms that come out, we've got to make sure these conservative libertarians don't do the same thing back that was done to them. We don't use bigotry and go to stamp out people's opinions that are opposing, because that's all that's going to do is put blinders on us and lead us into darkness as a country, as a nation, and people globally as well are going to be led into a darkness where you actually don't know what is true or what's not true because you don't have challenging positions.